everybody, welcome to another video episode of Bernardo's Tech Blog. Today I'm going to be starting what should be an interesting project of turning this satellite dish into a parabolic solar cooker. In this video I'm going to be concentrating on showing you the conversion process, and then in later videos I'll show you some of the food you can cook with a parabolic solar cooker like this. So feel free to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss those future episodes. Alright, to start with, I'm going to remove some of the stuff that we don't need. Obviously, I don't need the electronics here, and I won't need the cable. I'm also going to reorient some of the mounting hardware here. What I'd like to do is mount this on some sort of a base, maybe a board or something like that. That way I can just store it in the shed, and I can just take it out and plop it down on the sidewalk or something when I want to do some solar cooking. And then lastly, I'm also going to change this nut out here to a wing nut, because this is the angle adjustment, and I will need to adjust the angle depending on the height of the sun in the sky when I do some cooking. As you can see, I'm making a little progress here. I have a couple boards that I used to make a base. I've also was able to change the mount in such a way that I could flip the dish over, and I did that because I think this will be useful on the top. Perhaps I can rig something up that I can hang the cooking vessel right in the focal point using this. So I flipped it over, and I also put wing nuts here so I can adjust this however I need to depending on the angle of the sun. Here in Pennsylvania, in June in midday, the sun is almost directly overhead, but later in the year, or obviously later in the afternoon, I can adjust it down so I can get a good shot at the sun even if it's close to the horizon. Now the next thing I need to do is add a reflective surface to this, and I think in order to do that I'm going to go ahead and take it off the mount. That'll make it a little easier to work with. What I'm probably going to do with this is, first of all, I'm going to sand it down. It is a little bit rough, and I think I'd like to sand it down and maybe put a coat of gloss paint or something like that on it to make sure it's completely smooth. And then I'm going to see if I can find some reflective mylar or something like that on the internet that I can buy, that I can coat this and so it's really reflective, and then we should be ready to give it a try. Alright, I have this sanded and painted black, so it's nice and smooth now. I got a little extra paint on and it ran a couple places, but I sanded that down, and I think I'm going to just leave it the way it is. I could put another coat on, but it's pretty smooth and I think the tape will stick just fine. Now here comes the challenging part. What I have here is some vinyl chrome tape that I got on eBay. I got a 50 foot roll for, I think it was around $10. It's 2 inches wide, so it should be plenty of tape to go all the way across here. I'm going to start with one strip right down the middle, and then I'm just going to put overlapping strips out to the side. Hopefully I can do it without getting too many wrinkles in it, so I get a really good focal point. Alright, I have the second strip, and I'm just going to put it right along the other one, just overlap it a little bit. And here's where I suspect it might get a little tricky because of the curvature of the dish. I might get some crinkles in it, and if I do, I'll try to get them smoothed out. One thing I'm noticing in hindsight is that every little bump and rough spot of the dish shows up through this tape. And so if I had it to do over, I would probably take a little more care in sanding and painting it. I didn't really see it as that important, but I do see the reason now why it should be very, very smooth. So that's just a word of advice to those of you who might give this a try. Now what I do on the edges is I just trim it off. So I have about 1/2 to 3/4 of an inch overlapping. and then I just fold it down. And there'll be a few crinkles there, a few overlaps, but that's not really important because that isn't the part of the dish that's reflecting the sun anyway.
All right, I have it mounted back in the base and I'm ready to give it a try. Forecast is calling for a couple of cloudy days, so I'm going to go ahead and post a video just showing the construction. Just stay tuned to my channel here and I'll release another video in the coming days that shows the capabilities of this.